Hey guys, in this brand new video, we're going to take a look at salts. So, what we should realize here is, whenever we have an acid or base neutralizing one another, we're going to usually form water as well as a second product. We call this second product a salt. And let's think of a simple basic type of acid-base reaction. Let's think of hydrochloric acid, a very common strong acid, and it reacts with sodium hydroxide, NaOH. Now remember, our products here are going to be, remember, HCl is made up of H positive and Cl negative. NaOH is made up of Na positive and OH minus. Opposites attract. This positive and this negative are now attracted together. Whenever you have an H positive and OH minus combining, you form water. Now the Na positive and the Cl minus will be attracted to one another, and they give us NaCl. We're going to say NaCl is our salt. It's basically the ionic product that results from the neutralization between an acid and a base. Now, we're going to say that this salt here, which is made up of Na positive and Cl minus, this salt can make our solution acidic, basic, or neutral, depending on the rules that we're going to see in a few seconds from these two ions. That's the whole purpose of this section. So remember, we're going to have to learn that salts are just ionic compounds. They're made up of a positive ion called a cation and a negative ion called an anion. Now, based on certain properties, these ions can be acidic, basic, or neutral. So let's take a look at it. We're going to say here, if we're taking a look at our cations, we're going to break down our cations into basically three categories. We have our transition metals, we have our main group metals, and then we have our positive amines. Now remember, on your periodic table, the transition metals are the ones that are found within the pit. And remember, our main group metals are just group 1A, 2A, 3A, and 4A metals. And then our positive amines. Remember, an amine is a compound that has nitrogen and hydrogen, or carbon, hydrogen, and nitrogen. So let's look over the first section. The rule says if your transition metal has a charge of plus 2 or higher, it's going to be acidic. And we're going to say if the charge is less than plus 2, then it's going to be neutral. So let's think of an example here. Let's say we have zinc chloride. And then we have silver bromide. Now remember, zinc is always plus 2. So when this thing breaks up into its ions, these are the ions we're going to create. Now, zinc is a transition metal. It meets the requirement. It meets the minimum of a plus 2 charge. And because it meets the minimum of a plus 2 charge, it's going to be acidic. Now, silver bromide, when it breaks up, it's going to break up into Ag plus plus Br negative. Now, technically, if you remember your solubility rules, silver bromide is insoluble, shouldn't break up. But we're just saying, theoretically, if it did break up. Here, it's a transition metal. It doesn't meet the requirement. It has to be plus 2 or higher. This is only plus 1, so instead of being acidic, it would be neutral. All right, so for each of these rules that we're going to go over, if they meet the requirements of them, they could be acidic or basic. If they don't meet that requirement, that means they're automatically going to be neutral.